Hi guys, it's Vin with Boris Effects, and in this tutorial, I'm going to introduce you to some of the basics of Primatte Studio and how you can use it inside of Vegas to quickly create professional keys on even the toughest footage. Okay, so here we are inside of Vegas Pro 19, and I'm going to be working with BCC Primatte Studio, a premium filter from Boris Effects available with Vegas Pro 19 and Vegas Post. Now, Primatte Studios is a powerful tool for pulling fantastic keys. Part of the Continuum suite of plugins, Primatte Studio will allow you to work with virtually any blue or green screen footage and quickly composite that with a background plate. Now, before we begin, one of the first things you'll notice when I apply Primatte Studio is that it's very modular. We have a lot of parameter groups that allow us to handle all sorts of situations. I have control over the spill, color correction, edge cleaning, light wraps, and so on. And while I'll cover those in a later tutorial, I want to focus on the basics here so that we can tackle most of the keying situations we're going to regularly encounter. I'm going to analyze my footage, clean my foreground and background, remove some spill, apply a bit of color correction, and finally work in a bit of a light wrap to really pull things together. So to do this, I have two clips here in my timeline. The first is my background plate. This is what I want to show through behind my actor. Now I've placed this on the lower track, and above it I've added a clip of my actor filmed in front of a green screen. Now I picked this footage because while it's well shot, it has a lot of common issues that you'll probably encounter. There's a bit of unevenness in the coloring, some darker areas over here, some wrinkles in the fabric up here, we can see the edge of the screen here and here, and while we're pulling a green key, our actor has gone and worn a shirt that has a green stripe in it. So I have lots of very common issues here that even with the basics, I'm going to be able to make quick work out of. Now the first thing I want to do is apply BCC Primatte Studio. Now I can apply this directly from the Video Effects tab, but if you'll remember, one of the things I mentioned was that we're going to deal with a light wrap. And a light wrap is basically blending the background image along the edges of the foreground so it looks as if the light from the background is wrapping onto the foreground. Because I have to get Primatte to work with both layers at once, I'm going to go down here and apply Primatte in a custom composite mode. Once Primatte is applied, I have a lot of options available. I can view my mat, take color samples, set up spill suppression, but the most important thing to remember is that my very first step is to go here and click the Auto Analyze button. When I do that, Primatte will look at the image and automatically select the green screen, just like that. But if your key is a different color, for example red, you will have to manually sample the color for Primatte. But with my green screen footage here and auto analyze, right out of the gate, I have a decent key. But if I look at his shirt, while a lot of work was done for me, I'm going to have to go and refine it a bit. So what I need to do next is get a sense of what my mat looks like. At first glance, this looks kind of okay because I can see the foreground and background, but if I enable View Current Mat, I can see that there's still a bit of work to do. This is by no means a solid key, and what I'll have to do is clean my background and foreground a bit. Let's start with the background, and for the time being, I'm going to ignore these areas right here. This is the edge of the green screen, and I'll show you how to take care of that in a minute. What I want to do is get all of this here and here to be a nice solid black, and to do that, I'm going to sample the various color shades and add them to my key. One of the amazing things about Primatte is that unlike other keyers, I'm not limited to a single color. I can continue to add colors to better refine my mat. To add sample colors to my background key, I'm going to go to the sampling mode dropdown and select Clean Background Noise. This will allow me to select various points and sample the color in the footage. For ease, I'm going to leave my mat visible. But know that when I'm doing this, Primatte is sampling the pixels from the original footage, not the black and white that I see here. I can use the sample point here if I want, but for better accuracy, I'm going to grab the on-screen widget and move it to a new area. For example here, where it's lighter. And then I'll click Take Sample. Primatte will add those pixel shades to the key. I'll then move the pointer over here and take another sample. There's no limit to the amount of samples I can take, so if your footage needs more points sampled, go ahead. But already, this is looking much better. Now there's a few spots here where his eyes are, and these stripes down here that I need to clean up. But because this is the foreground clip, I need to change my sample mode to clean foreground noise. Unlike before, which added sample colors to my background key, this will subtract sample colors from my foreground object. I'll just move my pointer to a darker section here and sample. Now you'll notice that as I do this, some of the background color pixels pop back in. We're dealing with colors that are very close to each other in terms of shading, so as I do this, I'm going to toggle back and forth between foreground and background cleaning, each time selecting different pixels and just finessing it until there's a nice balance. One thing to be careful about though, I want to make sure that when I'm cleaning the foreground, I have foreground selected, and when cleaning background, I have the background selected. Otherwise, I won't get the correct results. Now, once I have something I'm satisfied with, I'll turn off my matte view and look at the final composite. This is looking pretty good, but if I look at different frames, I can see that around his hair and hands, there's still some green screen that's spilling around the edges. Now, rather than try to refine the matte any further, what I want to do is suppress that color. Now, I could go into my spill parameter group and manually set this up, but Primatte Studio has an extremely advanced spill suppression feature. Rather than trying to manually select a complementary color, I'm going to let Primatte Studio do the hard work for me by enabling secondary spill remover. Because Primatte has analyzed the color of my green screen, it's going to automatically limit those pixels and select the correct complementary color. Now, if I need to, I can open up the group manually and adjust the intensity of the suppression, but honestly, this is looking pretty great. Okay, so what about these edges? How do we get rid of them? There are two ways, and Primatte makes that incredibly easy. We just need to crop them out, and to do that, we want to create a mask. Now, if I scroll down, I can see that we have two masking options, outside mask and inside mask. Outside masks are generally used for garbage masks to quickly remove areas of our image that can either not be keyed, for example, the green screen edge or a boom mic, while inside masks are for areas we want to keep in that would otherwise be keyed out, for example, reflective jewelry or the green stripe in the middle of his t-shirt. For this, I'm going to enable outside mask by selecting either crop or mocha mask. Crop is best used when there's little to no motion in the shot. It's going to crop the foreground with a fixed edge, which looks fine until our actor moves out of the frame and, well, the illusion breaks. In this case, where I have very little movement, I can simply adjust the crop edge to compensate. But if that's not working in your footage, another solution is to select Mocha Mask. I'll open up the group and launch Mocha. This will allow me to create a spline shape that not only works with my talent, but then can be motion tracked inside of Mocha to allow for even greater control. But it's worth noting that if you create a Mocha Mask, when you save out, the foreground is going to disappear. So what I need to do is select Invert Outside Mask to reverse that, and there you go. For more information on working with Mocha and Pixel Chooser to create simple masks and motion tracking, head on over to the Boris FX website for detailed tutorials and guides. Now the last two things that we want to do is give a little bit of color correction and take care of that light wrap. To add color correction, I'm going to scroll down and enable color correction. Inside the parameter group, I can adjust the contrast, temperature, tint, saturation, etc. I can tweak these until I get something that pops nicely. Now it's important to note that changes are only applied to the foreground and not the background. This is going to allow me to match the temperature and contrast and saturation of my foreground clip to the background. Finally, I'm going to go down to my light wrap edge and enable that. Because I applied this in composite mode, my background is going to be defined as source B, which is the lower track. Light wrap is going to use the luminance of the background layer along the outer edge of my foreground. As I make adjustments to the width and softness, if you look at his hair, you can see that the glow from the light behind him begins to wrap around, blending him into the scene. If I toggle this on and off, you can see just how well that works. And when I play it back, there you go. Now, while this looks good, there is one more tiny tweak I want to add to this. If I look carefully at the edges of my composite, even though I have a good light wrap, good color correction, there's still a slight harshness along the edges of my foreground. This is common when the alpha edges get compressed, so I just want to smooth that out a bit. And to do this, I'm going to go up to my Edge Cleaner group and enable that. When I do, I get a message here indicating that I need to change my spill settings. Now this is a different setting from my secondary spill remover that we looked at earlier. What I want to do is open up my primary spill suppression group and change the replace mode from complementary to softened background. When I do that, my Edge Cleaner is going to use my background image to help clean up the edges along my foreground. I can make adjustments to the radius, sensitivity, intensity. I also want to enable temporal smoothing, which will allow me to help smooth these jagged edges around his ears. When I toggle that on and off, you can see that that really helps clean things up nicely. If I play everything back, that looks fantastic. Now, by no means is this all there is to Primatte Studio, but by scratching the surface of this powerful tool, you can see just how easy it is to take even difficult footage and pull a quick, professional key. I'm Vin Morreale with Boris Effects, and for more great tutorials, including advanced Primatte tutorials, don't forget to check out the Boris Effects website. Take care!